Good morning, students. This is Alpha Matriculation High Secondary School, Puducherry. Today we are going to see Chapter 2 in Commerce, Functions of Management. In the previous chapter, we have learned what is management and what are the principles of management. In this lesson, we will learn about the functions of management. Functions of management. Management functions are called as managerial process. This process is 24 hours non-stop process, and this process goes on till the organizational goal is achieved. We can classify the functions of management into two. One is main function, the other one is subsidiary function. First, we'll see what are the main functions of management. The main functions of management are planning, organizing, staffing, directing, motivating, controlling, and coordinating. The first function, planning. Planning is a primary function of management. Planning refers to decide in advance. Planning should take place before doing. What should be done, where, how, and who shall do it? For example, you arrange a tour program. So what will you do? You plan everything, like when to start, where to stay, which route you have to go. So you make a plan. In the same way, in an organization, planning should be done before doing anything. Nothing can be done without planning. The second function is organizing. It is the process of creating a good relationship among the members of the organization and also to create a network of relationship among them. Organization function work is assigned to employees who are given authority to carry out the work assigned and made accountability for it. The next function is staffing. Staffing function comprises the activities of selection and placement of competent personnel. In other words, we can say that staffing refers to placement of right person in the right job. For a successful enterprise, the staffing function is very important. It has to appoint a right person in the right job. Staffing also includes selection of right person. If training is needed for that person, training has to be given. And sufficient salary has to be given, promotion for the person. So all these comes under the staffing function. The next function is directing. Directing denotes motivating, leading, guiding, and communicating with subordinates on an ongoing basis in order to accomplish preset goals. That is, in the directing principle, the manager has to motivate the subordinates. He has to lead them, guide them, and he must have a good communication with his subordinates. So this will help in the achievement of the organizational goals. If any important matters should be informed to the employees through circulars, instruction manuals, notice board, meetings can be contacted. So in this way, employees can be informed about the necessary matters. So this will help to reach the preset goals. The next function is motivating. The goals are achieved with the help of motivation. Motivation includes increasing the speed of performance of a work and developing a willingness on the part of workers. The goals are achieved with the help of motivation. That is, the worker should be motivated. And this work is done by a resourceful leader. How the workers are motivated. The workers, they expect something from the organization. For example, a favorable working condition, fair treatment, a good remuneration, effective communication, incentives, etc. So if they are provided with all these, they are motivated, and because of this, the goals are achieved. Next, the controlling function. It is a control function which facilitates synchronization of actual performance with predetermined standards. Synchronization, it is the integration of actual performance with predetermined standards. So this function helps to evaluate or find out the performance of a worker, and it also helps the management to decide the increments and promotion of the worker. It also helps to find out how is the performance of a worker and if any training is needed for the worker, and that is also provided for that worker. The last main function of management is coordination. It is the synchronization of the actions of all individuals working in the enterprise in different capacities. So it is a unification or integration of the actions of all the employees who are working in an organization for the purpose of achieving the common objectives. So this coordination function is included in all the managerial functions. For example, planning, organizing, directing, staffing, etc. The difficulty of coordination depends upon the size of the organization. If the organization is big, the difficulty of coordination also increases. The next topic we are going to see is subsidiary function. Innovation, representation, decision making, communication. These are the subsidiary functions of management. You can say it as secondary function of management also. The first subsidiary function is innovation. Innovation refers to the preparation of personnel and organization to face the changes made in the business world. It is creativity to introduce new ideas, processes, or products. This function relates to research and development, which is essential for every organization in the age of competition. And consumers are satisfied with new innovation. So you can say innovation, that is developing new material, new products, new techniques, introduction, new packages, and also the consumers are satisfied by cost reduction. The next function is representation. A manager has to act as representative of the company. That is, a manager has to represent his organization to outsiders. For example, a manager has to deal with customers, suppliers, government officials, banks, financial institutions, etc. So the manager should have good relationship with these people and agencies so as to attain the organizational goal. Next, decision making. Every employee of an organization has to take a number of decisions every day. Decision making helps in the smooth functioning of an organization. An important job of a manager is decision making. Every day he has to decide about doing or not doing the specific work. Next, Communication. Communication is the transmission of human thoughts, views, or opinions from one person to another person. Workers are informed about what should be done, where it is to be done, how it is to be done, and when it is to be done. In a business management, ideas, objectives, instructions, suggestions, etc. have to be exchanged among the managerial staffs for the purpose of planning, executing the business policies. Students, we shall recall what we have learnt in this chapter. So we have seen two types of managerial function. One is the main function, the other one is the subsidiary function. The main functions are planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, and coordinating. And subsidiary functions are innovation, decision making, representation, and communication.